How's it going, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Danganronpa Trigger Happy Havoc.
Wahoo!
So, last time, we continued through the trial, and we confronted Byakuya about stuff, how he might be Genocide Jack, but then we found out that we actually have Genocide Jill in our class, so...
Crazy how yeah. That happens.
So now Kyoko has something to show us, and we are going to take a little break from the trial to go see what it is. So yeah, let's go.
Wait. Just what do you think you're doing?
Don't worry.
Kills you.
This'll make the whole trial more exciting. I'm sure that thought must please you.
No.
Huh? It'll make things more exciting?
Why didn't you say that in the
right
first
then.
Place?
I declare an official class trial recess.
For real?
For realsies?
Now then, what is it you want to show us? It better not be boring or I'll be very unhappy.
Oh, I have no doubt it'll meet your lofty expectations. So, shall we go?
Did you just call me a loft?
Yes. So before I even knew what was happening, the class trial had been put on hold. We headed off with Kyoko in the lead, and she tripped.
Oh.
And where she took us was hell.
All right, everyone, get off. We're at hell.
She took us to the batting cages, where she proceeded to shoot us with baseballs.
No!
The girls' locker room?
Oh, I'm surprised this is voiced.
We've already searched this place top to bottom! What are you trying to pull, Missy?
Ooh, he pulled
I'd
out
like
a Missy.
I'd like you to examine the victim's body one more time.
Thoroughly. You want to check it again?
Be sure to examine the entire body very carefully. Take your time.
I don't want to.
Don't tell me what to do.
Examine her carefully?
Not you.
Like, using our hands? No way!
You know, this just occurred to me. I don't know if this is just a coincidence, but there is a character in Ace Attorney Investigations 2. For any of you guys who have played that game, there is a character who does this exact mannerism and says, no way, over and over and over. And I wonder if that's a reference to it. But probably isn't, but maybe it is. They both release around the same time.
It's
so I'm curious.
Probably best if I don't run my hands all over a girl's dead body.
Because it is an Ace Attorney, and Danganronpa is at least somewhat similar, so.
It's not that I'm creeped out or anything, it's just based on religious grounds, you know?
Very well, I'll do it.
Sakura walks over and just breaks Chihiro in half.
But you're a girl. You shouldn't have to touch a dead body. Just let one of the boys do it.
No, it's okay. I think Chihiro would rather have a girl examine her. So just leave this to me.
Chihiro wakes up. Actually, I don't know. I don't want anybody to
examine her.
Sakura.
What?
What is it? Some kind of secret girl-on-girl action? Is that what you two are about? That's not it at all. Stop screwing around.
Quit screwing Erno. Sorry, I was going to say Romano. Quit fucking around.
Okay, here I go.
She just goes, okay, and that's it.
I'm sorry, Chihiro. Please excuse the intrusion.
Punches you through the wall.
Punches her whole head off.
I'm going to use this.
Punching bag. Putting her hands together in a brief prayer, Sakura then began to quietly examine her body.
Be sure to check her entire body.
I know what I'm doing.
And I believe we will solve this
particular. Shut the
fuck up. I know how to examine a body.
Her entire body.
This isn't my first time doing this.
I know you say that, but
fucking metal.
This is. What is this?
All right, guys, run.
Not possible. It's not possible.
Sakura's eyes were staring wildly at Chihiro's lifeless form. Her massive frame trembled.
This girl is...
Is what?
Is a boy! Ah, I see. So she was actually a he. Interesting. Thank you for confirming this fact.
What?
You're joking, right?
I wouldn't joke about this.
Ren... It's really true?
Wow.
Chihiro was a guy? Oh, what? You guys didn't know? Heck, I knew that right off the bat. Chihiro Fujisaki was totally a guy. Then he was a cross-dresser? Oh, I'm really on fire. I wish I had killed him. So that's what Kyoko wanted to show everyone, huh? Interesting.
Oh, so now you're not gonna talk to me, huh?
Yes, that certainly does make things much more exciting. Now let's ride this wave of excitement back to the courtroom and get back to the trial.
No.
And what if I don't?
Makoto just stayed behind and he died for it.
I do apologize for keeping you waiting. Now then, let's resume the class trial. We've all just learned of the shocking revelation that Chihiro was actually a boy. Let's pick up from there.
Okay, nobody talks.
Yes, well, I don't know his reason for hiding it, but the fact is, Chihiro was not a girl, but a boy.
I think Chihiro was actually a guy. The thought had never even crossed my mind.
Oh, I thought he said, I think that Chihiro was actually a guy. We just fucking said that.
Yeah, I would not put it past Danganronpa developers to write that.
Assuming his handbook did, in fact, list his gender as male, then yes, that would be true.
Shut the fuck up.
Of course his handbook said he was a boy. He dressed like a girl, but he was a boy through and through.
So then, there should be no issue with Makoto's initial assertion. The victim was killed in the boys' locker room, and was then later moved to the girls' locker room.
For
fun. And the killer could have easily used Sayaka or Junko's handbook to get into the girls' locker room.
So Chihiro really was killed in the boys' locker room?
So let's just pin it all on Byakuya then.
I still don't understand the motive
Byakuya,
for moving the body.
This was you.
But yes, that does seem plausible.
Well, I must admit, I did find it rather odd. I knew he felt a little off. There was a certain incongruity
You're
to
literally...
his female body.
I'm gonna pull the skin off your body.
The last time, I'm gonna rip every individual hair out of your fucking skull.
I'm gonna take every pore you own and fill it with cement.
All the mysteries have finally become clear.
Okay, well, connected or clear or whatever, we still think you're the killer, remember?
Yeah, I agree with you, Owie. Let's vote for him.
Very interesting. This has become very interesting indeed.
Ah, he's off in his own little world.
What about you, Makoto? After everything we've learned, do you still think Byakuya's the killer?
Yeah, bro.
My conscience 100%. Tells me to vote for him.
Yeah, well, lay it all down on the line. You gotta commit.
The one that made Chihiro's death look like genocide. Jack did it, but...
But I...
No, just do it, Makoto.
I think he might not actually be the killer after all.
What? But aren't you the one who accused him in the first place?
Oh, man, aren't you the one that has contributed nothing to this fucking case? So yeah, shut the fuck up.
Like he's enjoying us solving the mystery. The way he's acting, it makes it seem like it doesn't have anything to do with him.
What if you're a front?
And you think that might be because it doesn't have anything to do with him?
Makoto just backpedals. No, you know what? Actually, I think it does have something to do with him.
Plus, the evidence he left
I don't actually know what I'm talking about.
How can I put it? Overt. He consciously chose to use the extension cord, knowing it could connect him to the murder. At least, that's how I see it. And Byakuya, when you found out the murder took place in the boys' locker room, it seemed to rattle you. And then again, when you found out Chihiro was actually a guy, if you really were the killer, that stuff wouldn't have had any effect on you.
So that's your thinking, huh? Well, it bothers me that you don't have more concrete reasons, but it's
I remember what I was talking about concrete 5 minutes ago.
I guess I'll mark it as correct.
Mark it as correct?
He's right.
Your
I am not the culprit.
Mine.
What are you gonna do if we still vote for you?
I just happened to
that would
come
be the ultimate flex. It would be a
really
dumb hill to die on, but I would. Like, actually...
Are you fucking with us right now?
Get him.
No, I am not effing.
Oh my god, shut the fuck up.
I'm telling you the truth.
Mondo just beat his ass.
Well, I find it very hard to believe.
Go ahead. Find it very hard to believe. You're free
to
be
executed.
I'm just saying,
if someone talked to me like that.
If you're really telling the truth, then why? Why do you do that to his body?
My reasons hardly matter right now. Uncovering the culprit is much more important, wouldn't you say?
You're dying after we get out of here.
Now then, if it wasn't me,
I'm literally just saying,
it?
Like, I really am, like, does the handbook say anything about the fact that you can't beat the fuck out of each other? Because it's not killing anyone.
Yeah, really. Like, Well, who cares?
I don't think I can say for sure without talking about it a little more.
Monokuma didn't care whenever Makoto got punched in the face.
Yeah, so I'm just saying, if you did five more, what would be the difference?
We're all good, aren't we? I thought it was clear Byakuya did it.
Yeah, let's just move for him.
Me too.
No, I'm with Makoto. If there's any doubt whatsoever, we need to explore.
Knowing Arlof, Byakuya would be like ripped to shit under that shirt.
Yeah, no, honestly.
We all die here.
Let's do it.
That's the sacrifice I'm willing to make all of you make.
Damn straight. Count me in.
Do you not have a mind of your own?
Of course I do. What am I, an ant or something?
Anyway, let's discuss this all as a group one more time. We still have time to make our decision.
That's very true.
Our lives are all on the line.
Excellent. Then shall we resume our game of hide and seek?
You were trying so hard to be like the leader or mastermind of this group. But if Byakuya didn't do it, turns to Sayaka's profile. Sayaka, you've been pretty silent this whole time. Why don't you add something? And who's the real killer? Who murdered Chihiro? There's only one thing we can be sure that we know about the killer. Killer's a girl. No, that can't be right. Murder scene was the boys' locker room. And again, there you need a guy's handbook. The girl wouldn't have anyone again. I better think about it again.
Shoot!
That's one thing we'd be sure. What if the girl stole Leon's old handbook? To make it look like a guy did it. Murder scene was the boys' locker room. Yeah, okay, this is just... It couldn't be genocide, Jack.
I got it!
Since the crime scene was the boys' locker room, you would need a boys' handbook to get in. Since Leon's handbook is apparently broken, the killer wouldn't have had to use their own. In other words, it had to have been a guy. But that's still not a lot. Enough. I need to find some more clues. Alright, guys, it's debate time. Library
Let's spin around the room.
Celeste's account.
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to who did it?
No.
Well, clues are one thing, but... Did nobody get a look at the killer?
No.
I'm sure if someone saw the killer, they would have said something by now.
Why, Harry, you actually said something, useful.
Perhaps someone saw the victim at some point. Even that might be enough for now.
Yeah. All we need right now is any kind of new info.
It's over. It's all over.
We're gonna die.
You wanna know who saw the victim? The killer. And only the killer. And it's not like they're just gonna turn themselves in. Game over, man.
Why are you talking so much?
Yeah! No! Not game over!
Not only do we have no info on the killer, but nobody even saw the victim before he died. Is that actually true? No.
Isn't there a single clue that might lead us to
who did it?
Well, clues are... Did nobody get a look at the killer?
I'm sure
if someone saw the killer,
they would have said something.
Someone saw the killer. Someone saw the victim at some point. Even that might be enough.
Yeah.
I...
All we need right now is any...
Wow, you suck.
What? That's
wow.
Not
wow. Concentrate so don't hard scare only me to like fuck that. Up.
Shoot.
Okay,
shoot.
I know it's.
I'm an idiot.
Celeste's account. I know it mentioned something about seeing Chihiro. On night before the murder.
Picking up the entire screen.
Chihiro was spotted leaving the warehouse. It seems she was stuffing some blue exercise clothes into a duffel bag. Presumably she was on her way to exercise if the clothes were not found in the crime scene. So maybe it's the first statement.
Isn't there a single
yes.
clue that might lead us to
no?
who did it?
Oh my god.
Shoot!
Okay.
Isn't there a
Library
single
Death Lamp
clue
not
that,
that
might lead us to who
oh,
did
is it the stain? Okay, I guess not.
Shoot!
What am I doing wrong? I know Celeste's account has to come up, because she saw Chihiro before he died.
I'm sure if someone saw the killer, that
perhaps someone saw the
killer. Someone saw the killer. I don't know.
Any kind of new info. The disappearing stain.
Bro.
What am I... Okay, hold on. Are we still talking about the lamp, then? I thought we already established where the lamp came from. Byakuya was known to use it. Extension cord had gone missing. Land cord couldn't reach the outlet. Am I missing a statement or something?
Who saw the killer?
Oh, I'm brain dead.
And only the killer.
Only the killer. No.
Jesus.
No, it's wrong.
Keep thinking too far ahead.
I believe someone else did see the victim before he was murdered. What do you think, Celeste?
I don't know what you mean.
Now that you mention it, yes. I did see him.
And you decided not to mention it until I brought it up.
Huh? Literally.
Oh, but I suppose only Makoto knows about this.
Yeah.
The rest of you had no idea, did you? That is why you're all making such ugly noises.
Whatever! Just hurry up and tell us!
Shut the fuck up!
It was last night, right before nighttime. I saw Chihiro in the dormitory.
Why are you talking like this?
I saw him stuffing a track jacket into a duffel bag, and then, I assume, he headed off to exercise.
Hey, I'm going to rob a bank.
But we didn't find anything like that.
I have a gun in here.
Oh my god.
It seems likely that the culprit destroyed them to get rid of any evidence.
And that is when he said something that struck me as rather odd.
And then he struck me. With a punch to the head. Well, I better get going. I'm kind of in a hurry.
Chihiro told me he was in a hurry.
He also talked like a weirdo.
But why would he be in a hurry? Only if someone were waiting for him, I should think.
So, Mr. Fujisaki was on his way to meet with someone, and then they were going to work out together?
But Hina and I had invited him to exercise with us plenty of times, and he always declined.
Probably because he was afraid you'd find out the secret he was hiding, right?
Which means that conversely, he must have trusted whoever he was meeting with very much. Enough so that he was willing to risk his secret being revealed.
Oh, what a marvelous friendship!
A romance, you could say.
The point is, whoever he met up with is the culprit, right? So we just gotta figure out who it was.
But knowing what we know, I can't even guess.
All I know is that they're a male.
No. You already have what you need to make the connection.
Huh?
You know who the killer is.
Do I?
Seriously?
I mean, I do because I've played this before, but...
Who is it? Who's the killer?
Byakuya.
Think back to the track jacket and duffel bag the killer disposed of. Focus on the details of these items, and it should become obvious who was waiting for him.
Are you sure about that?
Shut up.
You really think we can figure out who did it based on...
Yeah,
because
I'm God.
I'm the only one with a brain. And Makoto eats it up.
What? You want to track down some fingerprints or something?
No.
Even if we had the equipment for that, we wouldn't know how to use it.
As was noted, the evidence is already gone. There's nothing to get fingerprints from.
Choke on air.
Maybe. But we can make certain inferences if we just take the time to talk it out.
Easy for you to say, but fine.
The sass in that comment, I'm surprised Kyoko didn't go like, excuse me?
Celeste. Kyoko does a good... rattled.
I know, she probably honestly didn't even think anything of it. But Asahina was like, I got her.
All the bags in there are the same, so I can't imagine what would make
that one special. You know, Celeste is the type to be like, that's why your parents are dead.
Well,
that's
if I remember right, there was a decent variety of tracksuits to choose from. Do you think there might be some connection between the culprit
and Sakura's never done anything wrong in her entire life.
Never. Sakura is probably the most pure one here.
Literally.
And Chihiro.
Perhaps. Let's explore that and talk a bit more about the jacket he took.
Does Chihiro's track jacket really hold some clue about the killer? Somehow, it's really hard to believe. Alright, I guess we'll do a debate about it.
The cameraman in the center.
The same evidence as last time.
First of all, we know where Chihiro was headed. He was on his way to go exercise.
Yeah.
So next we have to ask...
Why?
Why did he choose the specific tracksuit that he did?
Because he wanted to?
Blue is
what
a terrible color.
Specific tracksuit?
I got it! He picked that tracksuit because...
Cool it.
It matched the one the culprit was wearing!
No.
So, what you're saying is... The killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him? My tracksuit is black.
That's what's up, Mondo.
We don't even have a tracksuit.
That's what's up.
I have a white tracksuit, personally.
Okay, thanks.
Thank you.
From the warehouse, if you must know.
No one asked.
Did any of that really help us get any closer figuring out who the
culprit
is?
I didn't grab the statement.
No way. Not a chance.
You literally started it.
You heard him, right? What he just said without even realizing it?
Unfortunately, yes. Are you saying there's something off about what someone just said?
Oh my god.
And Kyoko doesn't bother to call it out.
Honestly, fair enough though, because fucking Makoto's sitting here like, wow, was someone potentially lying?
So next we have to ask.
Alright, so.
Why did he choose?
I need to remember if I need to extract a statement. Actually, no, I think.
What do you mean the specific
Celeste's account? Because she didn't tell anybody else.
He picked that tracksuit because.
I think.
It matched the one the culprit was wearing.
So, what you're saying, the killer was wearing the same blue tracksuit as him?
Yep.
No, that's wrong.
And this is when my heart broke when playing this chapter. You just had to say blue tracksuit.
Hold on a second, Mondo. What did you just say?
Nothing. Nothing, dude.
Man, this hurts.
When Celeste testified a few minutes ago, she said.
See? And like. Actually, I'm not gonna elaborate just yet.
Just so you know, your mic is covering like
said anything about
the first
color.
Three or four letters of it. Oh wait, that's a lot more than I thought. Yeah, now we're good. I'm sitting here like, so she never said anything about the jacket's color, so it was she was covered and nah. And I was like, huh.
So why did you say Chihiro's blue tracksuit?
Come on, Mondo.
What are you just
Hey, Celeste. What color was Chihiro's tracksuit?
As a matter of fact, it was...
Actually,
blue?
Shut up.
And before we began the trial, did you tell anyone that?
The only one I told about any of this was you.
And Mondo.
Then...
I told him as well.
Mondo, how did you know what color Chihiro's tracksuit was?
Well, because I just...
I fucking love you, man. And this is so wrong.
Investigation?
Yeah, talk. I cover for him.
That's your bro.
That can't be it.
Stop.
The bag and clothes were surely disposed of by the time we began our investigation.
I walked by the warehouse, you know, at night. Just happened to see him.
Then the only reason he could have known what color the tracksuit was is if he saw Cherry with it before he died. That's the only possibility.
Cherry? Are you talking about Chihiro?
So, how about it? Did you see the tracksuit or didn't you?
Just by chance. I just happened to see it last night. He walked past me, and he was carrying the tracksuit in his hands.
No, that can't be it either. According to Celeste's testimony...
Balls. She stuffed the jacket into her bag in a hurry, almost like she was trying to hide it. Just like that, she was gone.
When Celeste noticed it, Chihiro made a point of making sure the jacket was completely in the bag. If you just ran into him briefly, you couldn't possibly
Come on,
have seen
Mondo, you gotta put up a better defense than that. Just say you walk past the warehouse. Like, who realistically, who would be able to disprove that?
I know.
Because Celeste had her back turned to the door, I'm assuming.
It would appear you've dug your own grave.
Perhaps.
Shut up.
But you handed him the shovel, didn't you? That's why you said what you did. Focus on the tracksuit and it'll be obvious who he met with? What a bunch of nonsense.
Ah, now I understand. It was all one big bluff, wasn't it?
See, Mondo would have gotten away with it if he had just said, he just omitted the fact that the tracksuit was blue. He would have gotten away with it.
Right. Your true intention was to draw a slip of the tongue from the culprit. That's why you said you knew who did it.
I'm gonna steal yours, your tongue.
Yeah.
Give it to me.
That's right. However, Mondo was my target all along. I had my suspicions about
no, he wasn't. I'm just kidding. He probably was.
Mondo has a heart of gold. I won't let anyone else say anything.
I know.
Why? What made you so suspicious?
That's a good question.
Because I hate it.
There was a certain turning
what?
Point.
What the fuck? She just ignored you, bro.
I was hoping you would go back.
That's hysterical.
Maybe you didn't
she just looked
it,
at
Mondo.
You and said, are you dumb?
You refer to men and women differently. You only call guys dudes. For girls,
yeah, I
chick.
Say the same shit.
I call everyone dude.
I know.
And after he was killed, you happened to refer to him as dude. Once I picked up on that, it occurred to me that Mondo knew something we didn't.
I'll call a dude a chick. I don't care.
Such a tiny detail.
Are you a witch? She's a witch! You're positively frightful!
No.
Oh.
I'm not the frightful one.
No.
Not nearly as frightful as someone capable of murdering a friend.
Aw.
Mondo, was it really you? Did you really kill Chihiro?
I didn't kill anyone! You've been all over me, judging everything I say, putting words in my mouth. What gives you the right to treat me like a goddamn criminal?
Yeah, you tell him, Mondo. I'm on your side to the bitter end.
Yeah, he would never do something like that. This is a false accusation.
Get him, Taka.
It's true. My reasoning on that is pretty shaky.
That was fast.
Well, this does present us with a problem. It seems we are all out of leads.
My time has nearly come.
My time is nearly shut the fuck up.
That's what my little ghost friend is telling me.
Oh yeah, that reminds me. Kifumi, weren't you telling me you found some evidence?
Really? What kind of evidence?
I actually don't have any.
Actually, you know, now that I'm thinking about it here calmly, it might not be all that relevant.
Jeez, does your confidence just get up and walk away? It's fine, man. Just tell us.
If you really insist, then...
I found a piece of lint on the floor. I think this might have come from Mondo's pocket.
Here it is.
Hmm? What do you have there?
It happens to be an e-handbook. I found it laying on the ground, so I scooped it up.
You found it on the ground, right? Then it must belong to... It's mine.
I looked at it, it's mine.
I have mine right here. Then whose is it? I better calm down.
Shoot.
Guess I'm gonna lose the trial now.
How did he embarrass himself in front of every- Oh wait, does this imply that he said that out loud first?
We know Chihiro's handbook was missing from the scene of the crime, right?
For a fact.
For a fact indeed.
You're just like repeating
totally
people,
sure
don't you?
I found it.
Then it must hold some clue about the culprit, right?
Well, that's what I was hoping. But it's busted. It won't even turn on.
I imagine the culprit broke it to get rid of any evidence after the murder.
That's odd. I didn't think the handbooks were quite so fragile.
Like your neck after I'm done with you.
You're right. They're not. They're totally waterproof.
Just a big sigh.
Resistant.
Bring me your neck.
KG to sew.
Rogue, yeah. Seriously.
This one does appear to be broken, as is Leon's. Sitting useless in the main hall, for all your confidence, that is a remarkably high failure rate.
Do you think there might be some kind of mystery in there? So how, precisely, did the handbooks get broken?
They broke, that's it. How did the handbook break? There's only one possible explanation. By... hacking it. Maybe they were able to physically hack into it and, like, destroy it that way. I told you, it's impossible to modify it. Try to open up its guts and the security buzzer goes off. And then a gun comes out. Well, I guess I can cross hacking off the list. Maybe you had some kind of bug you could exploit. Too bad for you, but those things have been debugged to hell and back. Can't afford a recall. Oh, well, I guess I should delete the possibility of a bug then.
Shoot.
I guess I should delete myself too. Because I fucking lost. Kyoko's like, are you fucking serious? I like how everybody votes for Makoto.
I refuse to give up yet.
It's like, guys, it literally wasn't me. But you're gonna vote for me because I got it wrong.
Hold on a second.
I saw him stuffing the thing in the thing. Oh my god, it was blue. Some flashbacks. Alright, let's try this one. So now that we said we hate him. The way he was acting.
There was a certain turning.
Okay. Still hate me. Alright, last time we said Chihiro. It's Mondo's. Look, it's the Mondo. I have mine. Oh. Well.
Oh, that's awkward.
That's awkward. Can you make this yours?
I got it!
I got it. After losing my life once. Hitting his weak point.
What if by exploiting a bug was actually like, I found a caterpillar.
Here it is.
Yeah! You remember that? Sure, maybe I let that slip, but I never told anyone what the weak point actually was.
But if the handbook is supposed to never break, and two of them broke in quick succession, then...
Then we can only assume that someone's figured out its weakness. You know what the weakness is, right, Monokuma? So, what is it?
You're right, let me just tell you.
I think it's a necessary piece of information if you want this to be a fair trial.
But if I tell you, and someone else decides to copy it, that would be very not good.
What else would they do that for besides murder?
Just tell us already! Why would we want to break our own handbooks?
For fun!
Oh well, I have a weakness for pushy demands. But you're sure you won't follow their example?
No.
No, we're all going to do it at the same time.
Then allow me to make a special announcement. The weak point of my cutting-edge e-handbook is...
Air.
When it's exposed to high temperatures for too long, it will suffer a meltdown and totally break!
I flippin' knew it!
You knew it?
Oh, that was pretty cringe of you.
I found the handbook laying on the floor of the sauna.
The temperature in the sauna can reach over 200 degrees. Strange how you don't get burnt, huh? It's because as your sweat evaporates,
wow, actually acting like
it creates
right
a cooling layer of air around your skin. If the hot air of the sauna were somehow pushed directly onto your skin, you'd definitely
you would
get
fucking
fried.
Die.
That layer of air would get blown away.
That layer of
That's
air.
Why you may feel a burning when you move around. So when you're in a sauna, make sure to keep nice and still.
Interesting. I learned one new fact today.
Talk us like
Don't
learning.
That is a mere trifling speck of knowledge.
Anyway,
Talk
if you
shut
found
the fuck
victim's
up.
Handbook in the sauna, then the killer must have been purposely trying to raise its temperature in order to break it.
Meaning the culprit somehow knew its weakness.
But how'd they find out? Monokuma said he didn't tell anyone, right?
Indeed. Quite the mystery.
What if they found out by accident?
What do you mean, by accident?
What if the killer took their own handbook into the sauna, not knowing its weakness, and it broke?
What do you mean the killer took their own handbook into the sauna, not knowing the weakness, and it broke?
They'd realize it was broken, of course.
Let me finish.
And it wouldn't be hard to figure out why. And once they had Chihiro's handbook, they knew they had an easy way to dispose of it.
I won't say it's not possible, but who would have done something like that? I don't know of anyone who took their handbook into the sauna.
I might know someone who did.
You.
Byakuya, I didn't ask.
Whoa, seriously?
I think the one who may have taken their handbook into the sauna was...
Taka knows. Poor baby. Who might have brought their handbook into the sauna? Really, it only could have been one person. Me. Before I do Mondo, I'm actually curious what happens if I pick Taka. Because he was also in the sauna. Yeah, it certainly wasn't me, but I mean... You seem awfully rattled, Taka. Could it be you know who it actually was? In that case, there's only one person left, it could have been. You know what? No. Actually, I don't want it to be Mondo. Because you know what? Suck my balls.
Hold on. Are you really... Oh, wait. Are you sure you've thought this through?
No.
Go ahead and take your time.
Damn. All right, let's do it.
Yakuya's just like, yeah, are you sure?
All right, Mondo. We got to do it to you.
It was me, Makoto Naegi.
God. They really did Mondo dirty. They shouldn't have killed him off this early.
Mondo, your handbook got broken in the sauna, didn't it?
What? Why? Why do you keep accusing him?
Mondo and Taka had an endurance contest in the sauna not too long ago, remember? And for the contest, Mondo just so happened to keep his school uniform on. But little did he realize, he'd also left his handbook in one of his uniform pockets. And when it was all over, Mondo discovered that taking your handbook into the sauna could easily destroy it.
No, wait, hold on! You've got it all wrong! He would never kill! I don't accept this! Show me the proof! The actual solid proof!
I mean, I don't want to believe it either, but I found something that proves it beyond a shadow of a doubt. Alright, Taka.
Oh, man.
Do this. Broken E-handbook, Aoi's account, genocide, Jack Case Ball, E-handbook, Cardi.
Let's test Makoto's assertion.
No!
If what he says is correct, then Mondo, you broke your own handbook.
In other words, if Mondo's handbook is actually broken,
no, we're gonna break
that
you.
Proves that what Makoto said is right.
Yeah.
Well, my goddamn handbook works just fine.
You're right. It does. I agree.
Look.
Yeah, Taka.
We are Taka right now. So we're like, yeah, dude's never done anything wrong in his entire life.
Mondo wouldn't hurt a fly. He hurt Makoto, though.
No, Mondo's definitely hurt people, but...
Even I don't want to believe Mondo might have actually killed someone. But I found something that proves to be on a shadow of a doubt. I think it's the Balcony Handbook.
Let me check. Also, this is, like, probably inappropriate for the, you know, situation. But do you think anyone's ever drawn fan art of Mondo, but... has drawn him in a cow costume? Because if you just add one more O, it's Mundo.
Mundo. Moo. I wouldn't put it past him.
If y'all find any cow Mondo fan art, let me know, because I just want to know if I'm right.
I need to know. Alright, let's see. Jingo and Sayaka's handbook still work. Soon to be Leon's, my Monokuma. Very unlikely that Leon's handbook would have broken.
Oh, I just realized I should specify. Don't show me anything weird, though.
Let's test Makoto's. If what he says is correct, you broke your own handbook.
In other words,
no, I didn't. If Mondo's handbook, then that proves that what.
Well, my goddamn handbook works just fine.
Show us.
No, it's wrong.
Mondo, I'm sorry. I'm sorry, dude. Breaking the bro code right now.
Mondo, the handbook you have right now. Is it really yours?
Yeah, the fuck is that supposed to mean?
The broken handbook that was in the main hall. Isn't that one actually yours?
No.
What the heck are you talking
Andy
about?
Andy put a shoe in front of the door to keep Peeta out of the room temporarily, and Peeta just shoved her big ass head through the crack instead and pushed the shoe out of the way. So, it didn't work.
No, I was trying to keep her out. It's just the door, it's like Ooh. Not level. So it like swings open.
Oh.
So I always have to keep something in front of it in order to stop it from.
Well, opening. She just did the thing where like if you take your dog and you pull their skin back on their head, their eyes get all weird. Sophia just was like, "I'm coming in."
I'm coming in.
What I mean is, I think Mondo swapped his handbook out for one that actually works. I think he took Leon's handbook and replaced it with his own. After
Dude,
all,
Makoto, Monokuma said himself that free time events mean nothing to you. This
That's
is your bro.
Right. The punishment it suffered wasn't nearly enough to destroy it.
So then, the broken handbook in the main hall is actually Mondo's, which would mean that the handbook Mondo has right now is actually Leon's, yes?
But doesn't that violate the school regulation that says loaning out your handbook is prohibited?
Well, here's how I look at it. There is a rule about loaning your handbook to another student, but if they're dead, they're not a student.
Real.
It's kind of a gray area, I admit. But no worries. If anything, it just makes things more interesting. As such, I decree that exchanging handbooks with a corpse is not a violation of the rule.
Well, Mondo, if I'm wrong about this, you're welcome to say so. I'm happy to admit I made a mistake, but...
Son of a bitch! What's wrong, bro? Come on, tell
Taka.
Him he's wrong!
This chapter breaks my heart every time.
You are wrong! You have to be wrong! Everything you just said is wrong! You made it all up!
Okay, then why don't we look back on this case one more time, from the beginning?
No remorse.
That
dear
way,
God.
Everything will become clear.
Like,
and we'll
okay,
all
let
see
me tell you
10
reasons why you're wrong.
Damn. Closing argument.
Let me brain blast real quick.
Depression. Celeste saw Jihiro in the warehouse with a duffel bag and...
did a little dance. My eyelid has been twitching for the past 2 days.
You have a major problem.
Okay, guys, let me just lay out all of my fucking ailments right now. My eyelid has been twitching for the past 2 days. Like, approximately, I don't know, like 4 days ago, 5 days ago, I got stung on my head by a bee for the first time ever. And then I gave myself a panic attack because I had never been stung by a bee before. I have a lump underneath of my ear right now, And the other day I was leaning on my chin and then I like took my hand off my chin and it looked like I had a freaking hickey on my chin because I like, I don't even know, burst a blood vessel? I don't fucking know. So anyway, I'm falling apart. Please send help. Send help?
Bro, nice to see ya. Yeah, this case just makes me sad. Weapon the killer used was the dumbbell.
Was my fist.
Hey, Chiro, wanna see something cool?
What?
Fuck.
Wow, I've never seen a dumbbell up this close before.
Splattered onto the woman.
Needless to say, she wasn't breasting boobily anymore. Not after that.
Which locker room did the killer move to? Oh wait, I'm an idiot. Why would Hero have gone to the girls' place?
Whoops. Whoopsie.
Is there one for the boys?
It's the remix.
God, this theme slaps. Right, now we got it. Killer took something from the other locker and switched it at the scene of the crime. Why is the crystal ball even in here? Got Byakuya being a piece of shit.
I know, for real. Standing there menacingly.
What was that Byakuya brought to the murder scene? Really could have been. Extension cord. Tied him up. Maybe he used to disguise what had happened. Blood.
What?
What an asshole. Where did the killer go after they were done? In. What happened? It broke. I think that should be it. Go back to the beginning, just in case if I screw I can't tell. This one's tough because, like, I can't tell if he's taking it off or putting it up. It doesn't really specify.
Here's exactly what happened. First, let's take a look back to before the incident. Last night, Celeste saw Chihiro in the warehouse, correct?
Why were you even in there?
At the time, she was apparently stuffing something into a duffel bag. That something was a blue tracksuit. You can confirm this, right, Celeste? With bag in hand, Chihiro headed out, even though it was officially nighttime. She made her way to the locker room, specifically the boys' locker room.
To bust
but
it
how
down.
Could the victim, who was apparently a girl, access the boys' locker room?
Imagine if, whenever you put these in the wrong spot, Makoto just goes, and then, I don't know what happened, if I'm being honest.
Yeah, he's like super confident and he goes, simple. Oh, this is in the wrong
because
spot.
was really a key, which is why he was able to use his own handbook to gain entrance to the boys' locker room.
Yo.
Once inside, he met with someone.
It's the gray man.
And the person
the
he
true
met was
the behind
one
two cases
killed
in a row.
Him. It seems likely that the killer grabbed the nearby dumbbell.
The killer was really nice and picked up the bag for her.
let me pick this up for you.
And that's where the bloodstains on the poster and carpeting in the boys' locker room came from. It was likely in the heat of the moment. The body was arranged, but the murder itself felt unplanned. Which is why the killer hurried to try and hide the act. First, pulling up the bloodstained carpet, then removing the bloody poster,
and then killing Byakuya.
And finally carrying the corpse into the girls' locker room. A girl's handbook was necessary to get into the locker room, of course, but this alone doesn't prove that the killer was necessarily a girl. After all, Sayaka and Junko's handbooks had been placed in the main hall. Using one of those, a boy could get into the girls' locker room without much problem. And that's exactly how the killer did it. With the carpet and the poster they brought with them, they got to work. They changed the layout of the boys' and girls' locker room in what you might call a crime scene switch.
Byakuya just comes up. Actually, here's why you're wrong. Fuck you.
That could have been the end of things, but no. Byakuya discovered the body and decided to intervene in the situation, making things even more complicated. So, after stumbling on the crime scene, he went and grabbed the extension cord from the library, and then he got to work.
I should have strangled him with it.
I know, for real.
He used the cord to string up Chihiro's lifeless body.
Okay, what would he have done if, by some odd chance, one of the girls walked in the locker room?
I know!
Most likely being Asahina.
Right.
What would he have done?
Well, everyone would have fucking died. Like, he would have died, and everyone else also would have died.
Like, he played a dangerous game by sitting there, probably for a half hour, stringing up Chihiro's body, when someone like Sakura or Aoi could have, you know, walked in for some odd reason. I mean, like, what the fuck are you doing?
For ultimately, no reason. No real reason at all. Like, because he didn't...
Like, everybody would have died as a result.
Dumbass.
Like, there's no way he'd be able to explain that away.
Then, using the victim's own blood, he left a grisly message there.
Could you imagine trying to explain that? Well, I saw her on the floor, so I thought that maybe...
I thought I could make it more interesting. Mondo did it. I mean, like,
right?
Yeah, likely story. Mondo definitely did it.
He wanted to create the illusion that Genocide Jack was responsible for the slaughter.
God, Byakuya is a fucking idiot. Thought he was so smart.
Yeah.
And around the same time that Byakuya was putting together this facade, the killer, having already disposed of...
Mondo could have had a 2-for-1.
Yeah, he could have.
There, they plan to destroy the last piece of evidence, Chihiro's handbook.
Actually, yeah, like, come to think of it, if Mondo had killed both Byakuya and Chihiro in the girls' locker room, I don't even know, like, how they would have gone about solving that.
Yeah, I think it's pure miracle that Mondo didn't go back in there, which, I mean, realistically, why would you? Like, he left on purpose, but, like, on the off chance that he had gone back in, he could have fucking killed Byakuya, and then he probably would have gotten away with both of them, because it's even harder to pinpoint two.
Yeah, I mean, like, sure, you leave behind more evidence, but, I mean, really, how would they tie it to him? But I feel like things wouldn't have gone that easily.
I think it just would have made it, like, significantly more complicated, and I think it probably could have turned into a moment of, like, maybe Byakuya killed Chihiro and then killed himself type thing, you know?
The killer knew that the handbook couldn't stand up to the
heat. Like, I feel like it just would have been a lot harder to pin it on Mondo. And also, I feel like the order of, like, how the debate would have gone, I feel like the blue tracksuit probably wouldn't have come up the way that it did.
Yeah.
And the reason they
moral of the story, Mondo shouldn't have killed one person. He should have killed two.
Yeah, I should have added two.
And that's how it all played out. Isn't that right, Mondo Iwata?
No, it is wrong. He did nothing wrong.
Mondo's a saint.
I do like Chihiro, though.
I do like Chihiro.
This can't be right.
And Taka.
Where's your evidence? Yeah. Where's your evidence? You need evidence. You need proof.
You like proof, Sir Defender.
You can't pin any of this on him.
Taka's such a bro. Evidence that Mondo is the killer. That already revealed itself earlier in the trial. All I have to do is check that one item of his, and everything will become clear. More?
Not at all.
Alright, I got this. I played Friday Night Funkin' and Rhythm.
Down, my guy.
And Rhythm.
Show me some evidence.
Show me your moves.
I won't listen. I refute you.
It's interesting that you have to do it against Taka instead of Mama.
Yeah, I know, right?
That's usually how it is.
I honestly think it's really sweet because, like, he's like, I believe in him so hard.
Yeah, I mean, who wouldn't do that for they're basically desperate at this point.
Right.
I refuse to vote. Show me some evidence. You're wrong. I won't listen. I refute you. False.
I wish I could just straight up say that. I refute you and then not refute you at all. Just take my word for it.
I won't listen.
Source, trust me, bro.
Show me some evidence.
Without any proof, you can't pin any of this on him. I'm sorry.
This should prove it.
I'm sorry, Taka. I love you. Break.
If my thinking so far is right, Mondo must have replaced his broken handbook with Leon's. In which case, we can just check each of our handbooks right now.
Damn.
Once we do that, we'll...
We don't gotta do that.
My heart just snapped 50 times.
Yeah. Yeah. I did it. I killed him.
See, this hits different because for Leon's trial, he's in hysterics. Yeah, and also he was kind of defending himself towards the bitter end, whereas Mono just straight up says, "All right, fuck it, I did it."
Which is like exactly what you expect because Mondo's not really like a no-nonsense kind of guy.
What are you saying?
I got no choice, man. After hearing all that, I gotta just give up.
No, man, we can still vote for Byakuya on this.
This is how we can still win, Mondo.
Go ahead, Monokuma. Get it over with. Ask for the goddamn verdict.
Monokuma's like, well, this is now fun.
Roger that.
Fuck
you. Wait, hold on.
No waiting. No holding on. Time for the moment we've all been waiting for. Grab your lever and give it a yank.
I'm the screaming, crying cat.
I'm gonna yank
right
your head
now.
Off.
Who will you elect as the blackened this time around? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one?
I sure hope it's the latter.
What's it gonna be?
See, if I were in Taka's position, yes, I'm very disappointed in Mondo for doing what he did, and very sad. I'd probably leave at Byakuya at a frenzy, because I would need to take my anger out on someone. It would be him.
I know,
immediately.
For real. Like, if I can't kill Byakuya, at least I'll, like, you know.
Like, Jesus. Kill him. I don't know how he's still alive.
What?
Uh-oh, it looks like this looks... Oh my god. Fucking balls. You got it right. Yes, it is so. The blackened that killed Chihiro Fujisaki was me.
Ta-da!
Mondo Iwata. Terrible. He was such a good character. They should have kept him alive longer.
Yeah, I know.
Unbelievable.
In case you're wondering, the vote was not unanimous. Kiyotaka chose the wrong answer. Like a true homie.
It's literally so freaking sad. They are besties.
Why has Hifumi lived longer than Mondo?
I know, for real. Hifumi should have died. Get rid of that. Get rid of him.
Yeah. You're treading very close in the danger zone, Mr. Ishimaru. You need to be more careful.
I think you need to not tell me what to do, you bitch.
Taka's one vote would not have steered the direction of this trial.
No, it wouldn't have.
I refuse to believe it. There's no way. No way he would kill someone.
Sorry.
No, well, he apologized.
What is this?
Why are you apologizing? Why? Why did you do it?
I don't know, bro.
It should have been Byakuya.
I
God.
Know.
Now then.
Well, it looks like Mondo's taking a vow of silence, so allow me to explain on his behalf.
Actually,
the story of the murder this time is the sad story of two men. Ha! Oh, but for anyone who doesn't really want to hear it, you hit the B button to fast forward.
All right, hit the B button.
Anyway, there was once a young boy, and his name was Chihiro Fujisaki. He had an extreme inferiority complex regarding his own lack of strength. You're so weak even though you're a boy. He heard things like that as long as he could remember, and he couldn't overcome his weakness. On the contrary, he tried to hide and bury himself further and further into that weakness. Take on the fragile form of a petite young girl. He had chosen that as his way out.
Nobody will be able to say anything about even though you're a boy.
But no matter how tightly he wrapped himself up in that shell, The inferiority complex he had already taken, or had already taken root, deep inside of him, and was not so easily weeded out. As it turned out, the shell was completely empty. The complex didn't disappear. Instead, it only grew stronger and stronger.
I'm weak.
Weak. Once the killing game had begun here at the school, he had no choice but to accept this fact. Byakuya, how are you still alive?
Oh, gee, look, it's Junko, guys. Remember Junko?
After all, this world is the survival of the fittest. If you're not strong, you don't survive. So why is Byakuya here?
That's a great question.
And then the lovely and hateful Monokuma announced the revealing of the embarrassing secrets, which of course included Chihiro's embarrassing secret, which I was more than willing to divulge. Even though he dresses like a girl, Chihiro is actually a boy.
Hey.
And that was something Chihiro couldn't let anyone find out, no matter the cost. When that was revealed, this would be the end. The hardened shell would crack and the armor would fall away. Without a doubt, those around him would torture him like more than ever before. Everyone figured being thrust into such a dilemma must have sent him spiraling into despair.
What?
And yet...
I'm sorry.
Sorry. I don't really want to talk about it right now.
But
I also don't want to leave things the way they are, so maybe I can talk about it later? After I try my best to become strong, then I can tell everyone.
Annoyingly, he used the threat of discovery to motivate himself to become stronger. I hate him for that.
My eyes are really big. Now's my chance.
I want to change.
I'm going to get stronger and accept who I am. Strong enough so that when someone says, even though you're a boy, I'll be okay. I'll get better.
You get him, Chihiro. With that thought at the front of his mind, he resolved to take immediate action. And so... Can you imagine if Makoto had killed instead?
Oh.
They couldn't find out that I wet the bed until I was in fifth grade.
I think that they should make another Danganronpa game, and I think that they should make your protagonist the murderer and, like, die
that'd
at some
be
point,
really,
and then switch the perspective.
That'd
I think that would be really cool.
Or if they make it, like, the protagonist kills in, like, the fifth chapter.
Yeah.
That would be one massive plot twist.
That'd be fucking awesome. Everyone move over. We're making the next Fanganronpa.
Hell yeah. Danganronpa 4.
Let's go.
That day, he made the commitment to begin exercising. He was prepared to retrain his mind and body. But sadly, that would be the first and only chance he would have at it.
Hey,
When he decided to start exercising, he thought it would be good to ask for someone's help. But he wanted to tell the person his secret first, and then ask them to help him from there. And the person he went to?
Yeah, that's right.
It was me. It sure was. The biker gang fella had been painfully clear about how important his manly promises were. So Chihiro probably figured that even if he confided in Mondo, his honor would make him keep the secret.
Uh-huh.
Plus, Mr. Macho Mondo was the very symbol of a strong man that Chihiro had always aspired to.
Maybe talking to Mondo about it will help give me some courage. So, wait.
What the fuck?
What?
Is Chihiro supposed to be saying that?
So he went and asked Mondo to help him become strong. That's not Chihiro talking.
So Chihiro went to Mondo to ask to help Chihiro.
That was his aspiration, and he thought that only with Mondo's support would he ever be able to come close to that.
Correct.
So that's why Mondo did what he did.
I took a sip of, ooh.
To keep the promise, he made it
that's
Chihiro.
Sour. Okay. I was gonna read that.
What? Did what he did?
What?
You mean, that's why Mondo carried Chihiro from the boys' locker room into the girls' locker room?
Indeed.
Yes, that's exactly what I mean.
Why'd he have to cover up, like, what he'd done?
Certainly.
That could have been part of it, but I don't think that was the main reason. The real purpose was to keep the promise between men he'd made to Chihiro.
Mondo is such a real one.
I know, for real.
But how does moving the body keep his secret?
Come on, guys.
Because
if everybody... Wait, fuck. If everyone knew he'd been killed in the boys' locker room, then everyone would have been arguing about how she got into the boys' locker room, right? Once that started up, at least a few of us would have immediately begun to suspect his identity. So, he tried to protect Chihiro's secret by putting him in the girls' locker room and stealing his handbook. See?
And Mondo did all that to keep the promise he made to Chihiro, who we'd also killed. Yeah.
He's like, damn, when you say it out loud.
Why would he do that? The more I hear you talk, the more I don't understand. I mean, you guys trusted each other, right? So why? Why did you? Because no matter what. I didn't want anyone to know.
I knew it.
So that's what triggered it after all. The possibility of having your embarrassing memories and secrets exposed.
What is this?
That's impossible. Nothing could have been that bad. Something he didn't want anyone to know, even if it meant killing someone?
You're wrong!
It's impossible.
Don't make me repeat myself.
Shut the hell up.
Yeah, can you shut the fuck up? You're dead. You're dying next.
You're dead. You're already
actually,
dead
yeah,
right now.
You're just dead. How many times must I repeat myself? To judge others by your own standard is the height of folly. Even if you can't comprehend it, he obviously can. That's all there is to it. What the fuck is your embarrassing secret? I want to know what that is.
I know.
What, that you're not
My
actually...
My parents never loved me.
That you're not actually an heir to the Togami family?
I know. Like, I'm a Nepo baby.
Well, while we're on the subject, why don't I tell you? That embarrassing memory, the secret he didn't want anyone to know.
Hey!
You know what Mondo did? He killed his own brother. Asshole move from Monokuma. Mondo, the ultimate biker gang leader, makes all the hoodlums and riffraff across the country tremble. But the only reason he had the chance to join a gang in the first place was because of a certain someone. Mondo's older brother's name was Daya Owada. Daya and Mondo. Diamond. Mondo had nothing but respect for him. It was because of Daya that Mondo ever got on a bicycle. Vroom vroom. Mondo's actually running after him. He's just really fast. Mondo's brother was his only family growing up. He was the only one Mondo could trust or respect. He wanted to measure up to his big brother, so he imitated him in everything he did. Mondo was the epitome of the starry-eyed kid brother. Meanwhile, the charismatic older brother had put together a local motorcycle gang. And before anyone knew it, it had grown into the biggest biker gang in the country. Daya, the older brother, and number one in the gang, and his number two, his younger brother, Mondo. In the beginning, everything was peaches and gravy. But when Mondo started to think about how he would have to take over the gang from his brother someday, his brother's greatness, his reputation began to gnaw on Mondo's very soul. The kid's gonna take over for Daya, huh? Yeah, Daya created this gang with his bare hands. Mondo just a walk for the
Yo,
ride.
Yo, kill that guy!
He's someone like that, really be a leader.
All that'll do is make the game look bad.
Never mind, the next two were even worse.
Almost every day, Mondo heard the gossip and whispers of the other fuckheads in the gang. Which is why he killed them.
Stronger
than Daya. Once. Just one time. No matter what, I gotta win.
Don't fuck with me.
I don't care what it takes. I gotta come out on top. And the night on this amazing, On the night of his amazing brother's retirement ceremony, Mondo challenged him to a street race. But during the race, tragedy struck. He went onto the opposite lane
yeah,
and ran into
a
fucking
moron. Are you kidding me?
Or a truck, whatever. Get out of the way.
Also, how'd you get that close before you... Like, you didn't see that shit coming from, like, 10 miles down the road?
The trucker didn't bother to move out of the way either. He's like, well, collateral.
Well, and also valid, because he's in the right lane. The other dude, Daya's just straight up like, oh, that looks like a truck barreling towards me in the right lane. And
well,
I'm
actually, it's
lane.
Mondo in the right lane right now.
Oh, okay.
The kid brother pushed ahead with reckless abandon, eager for victory, and dashed into oncoming traffic into a truck. But suddenly...
Oh, even more of an idiot. No, just kidding.
What if Mondo had died? Because like they were probably going like 80 miles an hour.
Oh, yeah, no.
What if Bro died after he pushed
him? That's like a pretty generous injury. Like, I mean, it's not that bad considering what was going on just now. He should be gone.
He should. Laying in his kid brother's arms, the older brother delivered his final words. My bad, kid. I fucked up. Sorry. Of course, he knew it was his brother's fault, but Daya never blamed him for what happened. Hey, kid, the rest is up to you. No matter what, you gotta keep the gang together. Because it's the team you and me put together.
Mondo's like, this was all a part of my plan.
A promise between men.
Daya!
Daya is die.
He decided to hide the truth of what happened from everyone else in the gang in order to keep the gang together and keep the promise to his brother. He could never admit to anyone that it was his own weakness that caused the accident. And as a result... The team was made even stronger under the banner of the kid who bested his big brother. Daya was going to lose to his kid brother, so he got stupid and got himself killed. That became the explanation for what happened. Mondo's lie became the truth. He wanted to lead the team so bad, he was willing to tell all kinds of lies about his brother.
I just...
You couldn't have dubbed that. I'm strong.
Yeah.
Strong. strong, 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 strong. And yet, he was weak. As soon as our killing game began, he realized, no matter how tough he pretended to be, he was just another weakling that could die in an instant. And then the lovely, hateful Monokuma announced the revealing of the embarrassing secrets. At that point, it was clear that I would have no problem shedding light on his secret. Mono killed his own older brother. No matter what, I couldn't let the other gang members find out. If that happened, everything would have been ruined. Everything me and my brother had worked to create would have been destroyed. His death, all the guilt I've been carrying around, it all would have been for nothing. So that's why. That's why I. My God.
That's Mondo makes me sad.
Did not deserve any of this. Mondo. After I saw what Monokuma had on me.
I like how this dude, like, straight up did murder someone, though, and we're both like, he did nothing wrong.
Yeah. Like, a lot of the fandom love Mondo.
I love Mondo. I think he's great.
I think he was killed off way too soon.
I do, too. I think he had potential. I mean, yeah, this is tragic, but also, like, fuck you.
Yeah, I mean, fortunately, there's a character that's somewhat similar to Mondo that we get a lot more of in the next game, but still. My head filled up with a kind of fuzzy uneasiness. It just started swirling around. I never felt anything like it before.
I
didn't know what to do about it. I wasn't sure what to think or say. But after a while, that fuzzy uneasiness turned itself into a rock-hard lump of anxiety way down in my stomach. It was right around then that Chihiro asked me to start working out with him. And right there, he told me a secret. Seriously? Jesus.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'm sorry I lied to you.
I mean, Mondo was probably wondering why the hell Chihiro's even in the boys' room.
I know.
But why? Why now? Why are you telling me this all of a sudden?
Huh?
Because, I mean, you kept that secret all this time, right? If anyone found out, you would...
But...
You're right, but...
I want to change.
Real. I wrapped myself in lies. I'm weak. I want to destroy that version of me forever.
His words were like a knife in my gut. I felt like he was exposing the lie I'd been living myself.
I have to change. I don't want to be weak anymore. You're so strong, it can't hurt you, right? Whatever your fucking balls, whatever secret Monokuma might tell us.
You piece of...
So what? You're just saying I should say it?
What?
You're saying if I really am... Or, yeah, you're saying if I really am, I should just be able to tell everyone my secret?
Huh?
I was jealous. I was jealous of Chihiro's strength. He had the strength to face his own weakness, try and overcome it. It was the kind of strength I've never had. So I was jealous of him, and that jealousy broke me.
What?
Are you making fun of me? I'm strong? Are you fucking with me right now?
No, I'm not making fun of you. You really are strong, Mondo.
I felt like I could hear something starting to creak. Something inside my head. What did he want me to do? What was I supposed to do? Was I supposed to just sit back, let my secret get revealed, and ruin everything?
What's wrong?
What the hell is wrong with you? What's wrong?
Damn you!
Why did you have to tell me all that? Are you trying to rub my failure in my face?
I just wanted to...
I just really admire you. I admire your strength.
Yeah, that's right.
That's right. I am strong. Strong. I'm strong.
That's what I just said, big guy.
Strong, 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 strong.
Strong!
Chihiro should have just ran out at that point. Stronger than you.
You son of a bitch!
And stronger than Daya! Wham. I don't remember anything after that. When I woke up again, he was laying on my feet, covered in blood. I had the dumbbell in my hand, and I was just staring at him, down at the ground. Hey.
I killed him. I killed Chihiro. Even after all this time, I'm still just as weak as I've always been. And thanks to that, I did something I can never take back.
Mondo, he was normally so aggressive, so angry. He hid that weak side away from everyone. That was his secret. A weakness like that lived in a heart like his and turned him into cold-blooded. Fuck. God damn it!
I like how he said that from the fucking ether. He's not even there.
Look at him. You see, you're all just like him. For a secret from the past, for a memory. For that, he killed another living being and what? Another living human in cold blood. He couldn't cut free from his regrets for the outside world. He doesn't know what true strength is. Do you see hope anywhere in there? Because I sure don't. You bastard! Just shut up, you son of a bitch! Go ahead and say that again, I dare you!
Yep.
Okay, I'll say it as many times as I want, is what I want to say, but... Unfortunately, I can't do that right now, because the time for punishing is fast approaching. Taka, just beat the fuck out of Byakuya, you might feel a little better. Punishing?
It can't be.
Execution?
Well now.
That's what I promised you, right? The black inn that disturbs the peace will be punished.
Ridiculous.
Hold on.
Now then, I've prepared a very special punishment.
For Mondo Iwata, the ultimate biker gang leader. No, wait.
Let's give it everything we've got. It's punishment time!
I said wait.
Sorry, man.
No.
I couldn't keep the promise we made. From one man to another.
I wanna die.
Watch me break my own jaw.
Watch me break Byakuya's neck.
Bro, for real. I'm like,
God.
No.
That should have been me. Like, he should not be getting off scot-free right now. Or he did. Dun, 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 dun. I don't know why the execution's so quiet. Look at this sick bike. I still think Leon's was more brutal. Mono's just making me sad.
I know. Yay!
Of course, I'm talking about more brutal to the eyes. I don't know how I'd compare how it feels to be freaking melted.
I know, yeah.
And hit with balls.
That's a bit much.
But at least visually, the ball one looks more brutal.
Mm-hmm.
No. Ding, ding, ding. Mondo butter.
So true. Don't
forget. Terrible. What the fuck? Laugh at death, and your soul will forever be at peace. Can't be. My brother. Another murder, and another execution. I want to feel again. Everyone's lives are taken so lightly here. I feel like I might be going mad. Maybe I'll just let it happen.
Taka sure is.
Yeah. I love Taka. He did not deserve any of this. Mana didn't deserve it either. As Taka's sad screams invaded our skulls, we were each forced to realize once again. But he, of course, had to. Shut the fuck up! Jesus Christ, I hate you so much. I hate him so much in this point of the game. What a disappointment. This is the end of the game. Do you want to die? Do you want to add to the game? Because I will gladly add.
Do you
want to
die? Andy Sprite comes into Danganronpa. Do you want to die? I'm sorry. Who are you?
Or like the man who's going to murder you. I don't even care if I get executed right here. Byakuya.
You would. You just come in there and you fucking murder him in front of everyone while you're in the like fucking where you do the voting and they're all like.
What the hell?
Dude, we saw you. Yeah, I know. Just so you know, guys, I murdered Byakuya.
I murdered Byakuya. By the way, I'm not even from this game. Then I just leave.
All right. You're completely insane. You know that? A game? One of our friends is dead. Do you realize that?
Yes, Maya Faye, we realize that.
Naturally.
Do you realize that? I'm gonna put my fist inside your brain.
Of course I do, because this game is life or death.
Hey. I don't have anything to say to you. I don't have a response, except that,
however,
I just don't understand why. Why did you go out of your way to disguise Mondo's crime? Are you a dumbass?
Why? Isn't it obvious? Because it made things more interesting.
You are so annoying.
His voice was calm, emotionless, like the voice of death. It chilled me to the bone.
Last night, made me want to vomit.
When the murder took place, I was in the library as usual.
Honestly.
So, you ignored the nighttime rule too.
I don't think you obeyed it either. That rule never mattered to me. I don't recall agreeing to it.
There is nothing to be done.
Well, I don't particularly care. Please continue.
Why'd you bring it up?
I like to listen to myself talk.
The night grew late, and I decided to return to my room, which is when I stumbled upon him. I spotted Mondo coming out of the girls' locker room. After he'd gone, I looked inside and saw the corpse.
What?
You mean like you actually witnessed the murder?
He was such a fool. He didn't have the slightest idea that I'd seen him.
Well, so when you're saying you knew who the culprit was from the very beginning?
That's right.
Indeed. But if that had been the very end of it, how boring would that have been? I mean, what a waste of time to have the answer revealed right at the beginning. Which is why I decided to lend a little helping hand. I thought it would liven things up.
You did all that to liven things up?
I see. So after hearing about Genocide Jack from Toko, you decided to use that to create a fake murder scene?
But damn, man. If you hadn't figured out who'd really done it, you would've been dead too, right?
Well, obviously, I would've revealed the truth before I reached that point. And who would've believed you? Let's be real here. Who would've fucking believed a word that came out of your mouth?
Certainly not me!
Of course. Byakuya turned and looked at me in the eye. Like, for him to reveal the truth, that means he would've just flat out said, "By the way, guys, I disguised Chihiro's murder."
Right.
But it was Mondo. Like, come on.
Like, are you dumb?
I can feel his sharp eyes piercing into me. Thanks to a certain remarkable someone, it never did. And I was able to perform an interesting experiment. Why are you so fucking mad?
Experiment.
Are you mad that I have half a brain and I can figure out what happened? Once I do decide to become the Blacken, I now know who I'll have to watch out for. You'll have to watch out for me, because I'll be the Blacken.
Because I will teleport into the game.
See, as soon as Byakuya would have said that to me, oh my god.
I know, that's such a declaration. When I inevitably become the Blacken.
It's like, oh, who are you going to kill? Because frankly, all of us want to kill you.
Right.
So, let's have at it. Try and kill Sakura, see how that goes.
Correct.
So that was your reason.
Are you satisfied?
No.
Indeed.
Yes, we're done listening to your story. Moving on.
Hey.
There's something I'd like to ask Monokuma.
Byakuya, I wasn't done talking.
Well, I'm done.
What's this?
Oh, I'm up next?
You
like to perform these elaborate executions to make... Wait, fuck. Each time, correct? I don't know where I got to make. That's literally not even there.
To make time.
My question is, why?
Because it's funny. Do you like them? What? But you know, this punishment, this despair, it's not just for you. All this punishment, all this despair is my gift to mankind itself.
What?
You're over-exaggerating.
I'm not over-exaggerating. These punishments are meant to transform all hope into despair.
Damn.
What do you mean? Huh? Mean? Mean? Mean?
What the heck?
Mean, 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 mean.
Damn it!
Good grief, I don't understand why you have to pick apart every little stupid thing. Whatever, it doesn't matter. Shut up. In the end, I'm going to stand alone as the victor. No, you won't. And everything will be revealed to me.
Ooh,
I'll ensure that doesn't happen.
I know.
Like, what makes you think you're going to survive all the way to the end?
Such a bold statement.
The noble son of a noble family. Truly, you understand me. I think this is the start of a terrifying friendship.
That's enough.
Shut up. I would never stoop to a level of a childish criminal like you.
You're
getting close to that level. Let me just say this. After I've achieved complete victory, you're up next. Good fucking luck. Good luck. I'm going to find you and kill you. Understand?
Shut up.
Oh my god. You are living in your own little... You really think you're the main character.
In the name of my family.
Oh my god.
In the name of the Togami family, for which victory is a foregone conclusion.
You're
bitch
getting
said
all
foregone. Who says foregone?
It was so cool. It's like you're the main character of a video game or something. No trash mob for you. I swear, whatever it takes, I will kill you. Temper. Sounds like someone needs a nap. He really just said, you're not all that.
I know.
God, Byakuya makes me mad. Monokuma's laughter pealed across the courtroom, and the curtain closed on the case of Chihiro and Mondo. And I pummeled Byakuya on the head.
Real.
But I knew that wasn't the end. The killing game would still continue, because the mastermind wouldn't let it end. For those of us who were still alive, our worst fear and despair kept on multiplying. It was the kind of despair that felt like a blind puppy in hell and more of a future than us. All of our courage, our effort, our friendship felt like it amounted to nothing at all. It was the worst kind of despair. This is true despair. This is advanced despair.
Advanced.
Well, anyway, like I was saying,
hey, Baldi.
This is a pretty good spot. Yeah, a really good spot.
Anyway, isn't it amazing how that girl went and killed someone before things even had a chance to get boring? Once things really get moving, it'll be like a roller coaster. There won't be any stopping it. Fear and despair charge forward at a speed nothing can hope to match. But I must admit, I'm disappointed. I went to all the pain and effort of making you part of the group, and you couldn't play your part. You do remember you were supposed to make the first move, right? Well, no biggie. Nothing we can do about it now. So just do your best to make things more exciting from now on, okay? After all, that's what everyone wants to see.
Yeah.
Yeah,
there's one thing I'd like to ask you.
As long as you don't want to know my
I know who it is, but I can't
fire do it away.
Who is it? The 16th high school. Here we fucking go. The 16th high school student I
know. My, my. You really took me by surprise there. I know I said you could ask anything, but super denied, ultra denied, demonic denied. Because you see, that's my ace in the hole.
And I won't let you near my hole.
And nobody be dumb enough to reveal that, right? No matter how close they were to their friends.
Okay.
Who, who?
Fucking weirdo. Well, you're a bear. Boy's life of despair. They killed off a lot of guys in this chapter. Actually, no, it's only two guys, but. Three guys, two girls.
Mm-hmm.
Are now dead.
Typica.
Typica. Oh, boy.
Got
crazy
right
diamond him. Present. Yay.
Heem, heem.
Oh boy.
Weeper.
All right. And with that, completely wraps up chapter 2. We are going to start the next one with question mark. But yeah. So, as always, if you all enjoyed and want to keep the series going and show us some love and support, you know what to do. Be sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. And we'll see you all in the next episode.